Let's discuss the concept of moving coil galvanometer. About a moving coil galvanometer, we can write that it is an instrument used to measure current in a circuit or to obtain null deflection point in a circuit. This is a common deflection type meter which you already studied in the previous section. A normal galvanometer which is deflection type is considered as a moving coil galvanometer. And now we'll also study about its working. And we can write that its working is based on the fact that a torque is experienced by a coil when a current is passed through it. That means when a current is passed through a coil, it experiences a torque if it is placed in a magnetic field. In that situation, due to the torque, the coil will start its rotational motion. And this is the concept which is used in construction of moving coil galvanometer. Let's discuss its internal circuit diagram and the construction and working mechanism. Here you can see these figures show the internal structure of a moving coil galvanometer. In this galvanometer, here you can see there is a rectangular coil through which a current is passed. When current comes, it passes through the coil. If there are N turns, it circulates and goes out from the other circuit. The coil is placed between two cylindrical pole pieces of north pole and south pole in which a magnetic field exists from north to south pole. And at the top and bottom of the coil on its shaft, a spiral spring above and a spiral spring below is connected. This spring is of stiffness coefficient C, which gives us an idea that if the coil rotates by an angle theta, this spiral spring will exert a restoring torque on the armature coil with the magnitude C theta. Now, if we just look at its top view, you can see in the top view, the situation is like this. Here, when the current is passed through the coil, you can see due to the circulation of current in the coil, its magnetic moment exists in the direction perpendicular to this coil. And here you can see the two wires of coil are lying in the plane of this magnetic line of force between the pole pieces. So, the angle between this magnetic induction vector and the magnetic moment vector here is theta, which is 90 degrees. So, due to this, it experiences a torque which is given as M cross B. And here you can see when the torque is applied onto it, the coil will rotate in clockwise manner from M to B. So, when the coil will rotate in this manner, you can see when coil is in its new position, here also you can see its magnetic moment is rotated to this level if it is rotated by an angle theta. Now the coil is in the plane of this magnetic field, which is along the line, magnetic line of force through which the two wires of coil are passing. So this is the new magnetic field, which is of same magnitude because the same magnetic poles are used and the separation between the magnetic poles is same. Here you can see this is a crossed magnetic field, because of which no matter at what angle the coil will rotate, the angle between its magnetic moment and the final magnetic induction in its new position will always remain 90 degrees. So here we can see that the net torque acting on it will always be MB. If magnetic moment we can write as INA, the product of number of turns, current and enclosed area, here torque can be written as BINA, it will be always independent of the angle theta by which the coil is rotating. So, in this situation here we can see one of the coil rotates in this situation, the torque acting on it is same, but due to its rotation, the spiral spring will exert a restoring torque onto it, which is T tau restoring, which is equals to C theta. So here, as magnetic torque is clockwise in nature, here you can see the spiral spring will exert an anticlockwise torque, which is anticlockwise in nature. And the coil will come to rest when the restoring torque will be balanced by the torque of magnetic field. So at this position, the coil will be at rest. Now, if a needle is connected to this coil, we can see, based on the amount of current passing through the coil, the needle will be deflected, which can be placed on a printed scale on which we can calibrate it for the measurement of current on which the current can be measured. This is the way how the galvanometer works. Let's mathematically analyze some coefficients related to galvanometer. So, whatever working we have discussed for moving coil galvanometer, we can say when coil is in equilibrium position after rotation by an angle theta, we can see magnetic torque on it is given as BINA, and if we calculate the restoring torque, we already discussed that restoring torque will be due to the spiral spring onto it, that will be C theta. And at equilibrium, we can write that this BINA must be equals to C theta. That's why the coil is in equilibrium. And in this situation, we can see the value of angle by which the coil is deflected. We can write it as BNA by C multiplied by I, where BNA and C are constant. So here we can see that theta is directly proportional to I. Now in this situation, we can see whatever amount of current we supply, there will be a deflection in needle which is proportional to the current. That's why this device can be used to measure current on a uniform scale. Here this constant we can write as S, so theta we can write as SI, where S, which is BNA by C, is called sensitivity of galvanometer. This is called sensitivity because if the value of S is high, then even for a small value of current, the deflection will be large and the galvanometer is capable to measure small values of current. That's why the value BNA by C is termed as sensitivity of galvanometer. There is another constant we define as K, which is 1 by S, and this is called technically reduction factor of galvanometer. In some problems, we are given with a reduction factor, and K we can calculate from this relation as I is equals to, in this situation, C upon B and A multiplied by theta, and I we can write as K theta, where we can say if some deflection is there, using this deflection theta, we can find out the value of current passing through galvanometer. And the proportionality constant here we term as the reduction factor of galvanometer.